talk about allowing God to control your life when it gets down to it, like your schedule, your time, your days. There's at my job, as you guys know, I work in the drug and alcohol facility, and I was a case manager, and now I'm a program director. But when I was a case manager, they say you're not supposed to try to get too close to your clients and things like that. But like I said, the facility is a small organization and small staff, so sometimes it's hard. But I've been there since 2011. Well, I started coming volunteering in 2010, but I was full-time in 2011, February 1st of 2011. And during my time there, I've only really grown a really close family-ish type relationship with two clients. I mean, as far as having my phone number and as talking and fellowshipping and things like that. But one of them called me while I was at the dentist, and it was an issue with me not being able to be found in the insurance system while I was at the dentist's office. So like my mood was like, here we go again, and blah blah blah. So she called me and left me a message, and she sounded very distraught, like crying and things like that. And so I called her back, and you know, I said, whatever it is, it'll be okay, because I'm thinking, you know, a bad experience with another boyfriend or something like that. And when she said, no, it's not going to be okay, first thing I thought of was somebody died or was her kids. So I asked her, was her kids okay? She said, they're fine, they're with me. And then she told me, you know, she went backwards. So, again, you know how we can get wrapped up in our own stuff. I'm usually home by a certain time. I'm beating Jared home, or I'm getting home a little after him. Oh, I have to pick his glasses up too. And you know, we just get stuck in our stuff, our little world. And that was a handsome little boy. Keep him safe, Lord. It just, you know, reshifted my whole day, whole evening. I'm just hitting home 2.5 hours later, but just being able to be used by God, first of all, that's an honor and a blessing, but to act upon it and move on what He tells you to do without complaining, it's the best feeling in the world. Because it's not He can use you and tell you to do something, and even if you do it, but you're complaining, it's like you might as well just disobey, you know, seriously. But I'm tired emotionally, because it takes a lot out of you when you're trying to encourage them to turn over a new leaf. Can't even talk. But I'm proud of her. I am. Jared called 1,000 times. He's gotten better, though. He's gotten better because he didn't understand, you know, and not rarely. When I say rarely, I mean rarely bring Jared to my job, because I just don't want him being around that. You could be exposed to it. You can know what I do and things like that, but just, no. Didn't understand why they were so, you know, clingy to me and things like that. And I was explaining to him about the disease of addiction and, you know, some of the things that people in recovery go through. And he's a lot better now. And he's gotten better. I don't know if he was okay today, because I bought him something to eat home, and I actually ate some. So, you know, I called and talked to him, and explained to him what I was doing, and he was really okay. But it showed me right at that moment, you know, for some people, your obedience and availability is their life or death moment. And I just thank God that I'm growing in Him, that I obeyed, and, you know, I just didn't, oh, I'll call her later, or, you know, because it was bad, you know, it was bad. So, we don't know where we can end up. We could be living half the hog one day, and the issues of life, honey, you don't know what you will or won't do. You know, I remember when I was going through years ago, it was almost like back to back. I was going through a divorce, going through things with my twins, and I called a prayer line, and they were rushing me off the prayer line, and the lady actually, I called two different times, two different places. The lady was like rushing me off the phone and things like that, and literally said these words to me, "Well, there's other calls in the queue, and I have to hang up with you so I can pray with other people," which I get the concept, but when a person's crying and going through, and you hear that on the phone, there's a certain way how to say it, and honey, she failed terribly. And then another one, which is actually like a local station, ooh, honey, she didn't even ask me my request. I start talking, and she just started praying. But she was praying very robotically, so I stopped her, and I kind of tried to give her a little critique. And she actually said to me, "Well, you're calling on a free line anyway, so whether we stay on the phone for 30 seconds or 2 minutes, you still called in for free." Honey. Oof. Jesus. It did a whammy. And actually, I've never followed, after that happened, I stopped following those ministries. I really did. Well, like I said, one's local, and then the other one is based in Ohio. And I did. I stopped following their ministries. So it just goes to show, we have to be careful. Because what if I wasn't already saved and strong in the Lord? And, you know, there's a lot of people who's even strong in the Lord that do crazy stuff. And, ooh, that thing is loud. Let me hurry up and get away from it. But yeah, it was crazy. It really, really was. Alrighty. Talk to you guys later. Have a blessed day. And love on those people who are really there for you, who support you. Love on your parents, especially if you still have them with you. Guys, think about my mama. It's my honey. My mommy's my bestie. All right, you guys. God bless. Bye-bye.